Right, cheap Chinese batteries. I've been pretty hard on them. With good reason though, as I've showed in previous videos, some of them are crap. But have I found one that is actually pretty good? So, I heard of these PKCell 18650 batteries on a vape group on Facebook. Someone was on there asking if they could use them for their vape mod, and the general advice was no, because not much was known about them. So, I decided to have a look into them. Now, they are a cheap 18650 cell. They are on eBay. They come from China. But they don't make ridiculous claims for either the capacity or the amperage, so I thought I would buy some and have a look for myself to see how they compare. Now, in a lot of ways, these are the polar opposite to the Powerhouse batteries I tested in the last video. They come with no retail packaging at all. They come in a plain envelope, just shrink wrapped together, four batteries with very little markings. Now, a word of note, they don't have any of the markings they're meant to have by UK legislation, but I don't think that seems to be particularly enforced. The main thing is to see how good they are and how good they work. Weight-wise, they all came in over 40 grams, between 42 and 45, a little bit of variation there, but heavy enough that there could be enough material in there to make a good cell. So as per usual, we'll get them into the charger. They've been fully charged up to 4.2 volts and we'll run them right down to 2.5 volts. Now, again, strangely enough for a cheap Chinese battery, there is a lot of information available on these and the manufacturer states that they should only be ran down to 3 volts, but we'll take them down to 2.5. Let's see how they perform. Well, that's quite good. They have the exact capacity that the manufacturer claims over the voltage range that they claim, with all four batteries given 2200 milliamp hours between 4.2 volts and 3 volts. You can see there that with 18650 cells, there isn't much benefit going below 3 volts because you don't get much capacity return for that extra half volt drop. But I wanted to test them on that same range that I've used for previous batteries. As I explained in the last video, the charger doesn't put a big load on these batteries when it's discharging them. The current draw topped out about 2 amps. These are spec'd at 11 amps continuous. So we'll use the same method we used in the last video. I'll adjust a coil resistance to draw about 11 amps from one of these on a full charge. Obviously that current draw will drop as the voltage drops, but it should still be drawing about 8 amps when it's flat. At the same time, we'll keep an eye on the battery cell temperature and that'll let us know if it's struggling to keep up or if it's supplying that power fine. We'll be right back. Well, that surprised me. I expected these to struggle a bit, but they handled everything fine, including some very long burn times. I think the longest was about 7 minutes continuous burn. Like I mentioned earlier, toward the end of the test, the current draw would have dropped to around 8 amps, but they were still getting worked quite hard. And while cell temperature did rise, which is normal for a battery being discharged quite hard, it didn't rise that high, it didn't rise to any level we needed to worry about. So, is this a vaping battery? Probably not. Not unless you vape at very low wattages or you intend to connect a few of these together in parallel to give you a greater current capacity. And that's just too much messing about, so get yourself a higher rated battery if you're going to vape. But for diving, cycling or airsoft weapon lights, which is how I got into these in the first place, they're a decent choice. With the 2200mAh capacity, you'll get good run times on low current devices. Also, if you're wanting to build your own battery packs or power banks, they could be a good shout for that as well. I'm actually quite impressed with these for the money, and they get even cheaper if you're buying them in bulk. My only slight point is that the majority of listings on eBay for these, they list the 2C version, which is a constant current output of 4.4 amps rather than the 5C or 11 amp battery that I received. But again, for flashlights and low current devices, that doesn't really matter. Even the support from PKCell was pretty good. I emailed them for a spec sheet before I tested these, and they replied within a day. So, does this change my opinion of cheap Chinese cells? No. I always knew there was good ones. Most of the cool stuff we use day in and day out comes in part or whole from China already. The problem is, with such a huge industry, there's also a huge number of places selling absolute rubbish counterfeits and low quality. The key is, as always, to be able to separate the good stuff from the bad, and PKCell seems to be pretty decent. GTF, Ultrafire and so on are utter garbage. Anyway, this will be the last battery test I do for another wee while. I want to get on with some other things. I was asked to look at the alleged 12,000mAh 18650s that pop up on eBay and Amazon from time to time. We know they're bullshit. We don't even have to check. That capacity just isn't possible. But I'll leave it there for now. If this has been useful, do all that usual stuff, like and subscribe. I'd really appreciate it. And until next time, take it easy, and I'll catch you in the next one.